be honest, I'm a bit concerned that we might end up with another mutiny on our side at the moment, and I think this guy might end up being the ringleader in it. What is it with me and captains?
Don't wait for me, 'cause I keep breathing fire. I won't wait for you, 'cause you keep telling lies. I keep going high, she keep going low. At the end of the day, she's gone.
And welcome back to another episode of Outcast to Icons with me, Kenny Rogers. As always, of course, if you're enjoying the save, drop a like. That would be spectacular. So, I guess we could say that last video went pretty well. Regan Booty smashing things up for us. Us just really starting to look like a very well-oiled, cohesive team. And that's what you want at this level. We're only a single point off the top of the league now. Now, obviously, we play currently top of the league, Paralimni, in today's video right now. Best goal difference in the league. This is one of the things that got us last year, was not having a good goal difference, comparatively speaking. And I really do think we've rectified that issue. And I expect us to be right up there this year, barring any major injuries to, oh, I don't know, Regan Booty. The start to the season that Booty's had is actually insane. 5 goals in 8 competitive matches. His XG is actually pretty high as well. It's not like he's just scoring low-quality chances. He's getting into good positions and scoring goals. It really is as simple as that. And like I say on every single series, I don't really know why. I've never really been able to figure out what makes Regan Booty so good, no matter what save I've had him on. And in this one, if anything, I'm the most baffled here than I've ever been before, because really, we're asking him to play the role that he shouldn't be particularly well suited for. It's a Metzeler on attack. And yes, okay, he has some okay attributes for it, but it wouldn't suggest that he should be able to do what he's done, particularly not the headed goals that we've been seeing from him. Although, you know, only 8 heading. Does have okay jumping reach, actually, for someone 5'10". So maybe that's helping, and he's just pulling into great pairings. But for whatever reason, Regan Booty is a monster. And can you imagine if he continued to be good like this for the rest of the season? Like, we could be looking at a 20-goal season from Regan bloody Booty. If there was one player I wouldn't mind taking with us to the next club and beyond, it would be someone like my man Regan, to be honest. To be fair, Stylianu's been sort of on the low fitness train for a little while now, so I'm actually quite happy to keep him in this one, as long as we've got Sergio on the bench. We've got the AA battery in the centre, so that actually, do I even want to change this? Or maybe I should give Christou another look in. Though it is a hard choice when Sawless is playing as well as he is at the moment, and given that we won the last game, maybe we should just give him the chance to stay in the team another chance. It's difficult, because we've got the player that is ours. He's a young buck. He's coming through. He clearly has high potential, but hasn't put in the performances this year. But at some point, I'm going to have to give him a chance to come back in again. But maybe today is not that day. God, for a second, I thought they had Danny Ceballos. Can you imagine? I think maybe we bring Christou back in against a slightly lower quality opposition and just see what he can do. It's also been speculated that Alexander Lind, the player that chose to retire instead of join us, may have well have started a jet ski company, which, let's face it, given this save, is not exactly hugely surprising. We can avenge them. Not sure from when. I guess the... Wow, look at this. Oh, this is probably the best team talk we've ever had in this save. Big fan of that. Right, let's crack on. Come on, lads. This is the one. A win against a team like Paralimni is huge. But we are at home, and we have done relatively good things at home this season, so I have high expectations. This midfield is just utterly filthy. Some of the passing plays we can get into, other teams just really do not like it when we move that ball quickly around the edge of the area. Now, obviously, we are vulnerable if teams can get a counter-attack on us, because we do push so many players forward in those positions. And Victor's into the position. Oh! Fombatas with the early shot. Don't know how Regan Booty was offside there. I mean, maybe he was, but I don't know how he was interfering with players. Mendy getting on the end of it nearly, and Gachevsky is there. But a strong start from the Ermisi boys. I expect Paralimni to be right up towards the top of the league this season and probably be our biggest rivals for... Oh, careful. There we go. Well played, lads. Got that. Oh, nice ball to Mendy. He's got to spread this. Goes for Fombatas. We're very, very narrow here. But he's found a bit of width with Mira. Back to Victor. Here we go. David Dynamite. Can he step it on the side for Mira, maybe? Or just find an awesome cross. Victor's pulling away. Ball in, and it's cleared. All right, this right here is where we're vulnerable. We know that, but we just have to accept that and try to do our best. Ceballos, round the side here for Alvarez, and Duvniak with a stupidly good save. It doesn't matter, it's offside. But we look aggressive today. There's a real pep in our step about some of our passing plays today. Really, really moving that ball around very, very quickly, which is lovely to see. Spaces are being opened up with it. Fombatas, Mendy, Arava Stylianu. Men in the box now. Fombatas again. Oh, look at the number of men he's got over. Booty could find Victor here. Oh! I just tell you what, this team has got something special about it. Vasilis Sorlis into that position again, and unfortunately, every time he scores like that, he is putting Christou more and more in the mud, so to speak. But again, just getting overlaps and bodies. Booty here, I thought Victor was going to go for the shot, but instead he just disguises a lovely little ball through, and Sorlis is on the end of it, and it is 1-0 Ermis against top of the table Paralimni. We would go top with a win, surely. I mean, we're making this look easy at the moment, and I am excited. Victor again? Or he could dig out across the booty, maybe. Mira, can he turn? Finds Victor! Victor again, and well saved by the goalkeeper. Wow, we could have two by now. Actually, not top, as Carmio Tissa are also winning, so we would not be top of the league with a win in this game, but we would be right up in there, and that's all we really want at this point. Oh, could win the flick on, but no, Stiliano brings it down. Back for booty. I want a prediction from you lot in the comment section. That could be your algorithm comment today, instead of just the algorithm stuff. What do you think? Oh my god. Oh. Remy Fombatas makes it 2-0. Whoa, the goalkeeper's on one. Okay. Just to clarify, I'm not seeing things. The goalkeeper did just perform some kind of illusion. Okay. Worrying. He's obviously put all his attribute points into magic. Never do that. You don't want that kind of build in FM, I'm just saying. Wow, yeah. So what I was going to say is, comment predictions. How many goals is Regan Booty getting this season for us? My prediction is going to be 17. That's a lot, I realise, but let me know in the comments. What on earth was that goal? Everything about that. Stylianu's ball whipped in. Victor's header, and it's in the bottom corner. And it's Ermis Arapadou 3, Paralimni 0. And this might be the best I've seen us play in this entire save. Any club we've been in so far. The performance in this first half an hour has been utterly incredible. Just runs driving players all over the place. They can't handle us. We get an overload at the back post, and the goalkeeper's obviously somewhat at fault there. Once again, see his build. It's 3-0. Koszewski, obviously don't concede. Oh my god, what a horrible clearance from the goalkeeper. There's a ball inside. It's Sorlis again. It's a tight angle, and Sorlis' shot is well saved. He is making some lovely runs. I keep thinking half-time is about to happen, and it hasn't yet. Fombatas' ball in. And oh my god, Georgios Antsoulis on the stroke of half time now makes it 4-0 to Ermis. These guys were relegated from the top flight last year, and I don't think they'd lost a game yet this season, and now they're 4-0 down at half time. This is so similar to that game we had earlier this season against Thoi, where we just hammered them in the first half. Wow. Firstly, 4-0, incredibly harsh on them, I feel like. We haven't created 4-0's worth of chances. We've just been ruthless in this first half. My god. It's nuts that their goalkeeper's made 8 saves and they're still 4-0 down in this match. To give you an idea of just how good we've been in this first period. I mean, what a perfect way to start the video. This is crazy. Haven't scored a long ranger today yet. That's usually one for the bingo cards. What is he doing here, Brooks? He loves spinning on the spot. Oh, picks it out. Fombatas, round the side for Mendy. Oh, well tipped over the bar, but lovely work again from the lads. Oh, he's got it around the side. Mercado. Right, we need a big one from... What a tackle. Everything about our defence has just been unbelievable in this game. Even, like, the last-ditch stuff is just crazy good. Fombatas. All right, cheers, Remy. Yep, thanks for playing. It looks like it is going to be Ermis 4, Paralimni 0. We got a bit complacent in the second half, but it didn't matter as we run away 4-0 winners in the top of the table clash. And astonishingly, I don't think we've gone top. In fact, not only have we gone top, we're actually now third. We've only moved up one position, but look at that goal difference. Plus 12 after 7 games. There's goals in this team. That's 5 straight wins. Let's play a few off camera. There's a couple of cup matches in there too, and we'll be back for the derby, I think, against Omonia Aradipu, who, you know, aren't having the worst season themselves. Right then, friends, we're back. We went away to Olympia, one of the struggling sides in the league, and our brilliant form just continued. Mira with the ball around the side. 41 minutes in, we finally broke the deadlock with Victor getting into a position to make it 1-0 to us. And in the second half, things just started to get a little bit more easy for us. We just found that space. Lovely ball in from Stiliano, and there was Marco Mira. He's had a few poor games lately, but today he really did step up and showed what he could do. Mira getting the ball here. Christou came off the bench. Eventually, Mira just slides it through, and Christou with a gorgeous little finish past the goalkeeper. 3-0. Game over, match in the bag. But as is often the case in games like this, we just kind of let our foot off the throttle here. Some poor defending eventually cost us, and Pitaris was able to get a goal back for Olympia, but it wasn't really going to matter in the long run. As a man on a mission again, Mira once again gets the ball in a lovely little position here. Christou gets it around the side and scores his second goal of the night off the bench. He definitely has that in him, and just a really good performance all round from us. Christou with the brace off the bench, really trying to prove that he should be back in the team. More on him in a minute, though. Next up, we had our first cup match against Paphos. A 0-0 draw against the top flight side, in which we were pretty much matching them pound for pound. I was very impressed with this on the night, and it did show a little bit of the quality we have. But sadly, with the fixtures coming thick and fast at this point, we put in really really quite a poor performance at home against Iron Napa. Now, obviously, they're a good side, but I would have expected more from us in here. David Dynamite has been absolutely ruthlessly good lately. Another clean sheet for the lads. We had a suspension in the defence, and unfortunately, Diego Gomez had to play there, and I definitely felt that that maybe hampered us a bit, having to rotate Hindley little bits, but had some tired players in there. So that was our second consecutive 0-0, and two games without a goal all of a sudden. And unfortunately, that lack of goal-scoring streak kind of continued. Now, albeit it was against top flight Paphos here, who we didn't really expect much from. But after getting that 0-0 in the first leg, I thought there was hope. They went in front from a doubt after just 11 minutes. Second half, we tried to throw some stuff at them to sort of see what we could come up with. But unfortunately, just a goalmouth scramble here eventually slid over the line by Brian Angelo to make it 2-0. Kind of put us in the bin at that point. And once more, again, we got a bit disjointed here. The players just weren't able to, they weren't able to string their passes together. Defensively, a bit worse in this match. And Paphos swept us aside 3-0 to go through to the next round of the cup. I'm not too bothered. We got to where we wanted to get to in the cup this season. We weren't expected to get through against these guys, and that now allows us less fixture congestion, and we can really concentrate on the league, because I do believe that with all the fixtures coming thick and fast, we just weren't able to put our strongest foot forward, particularly in games like this. So that still leaves us second in the league, as Carmio Tissa have actually won 6 of their first 9 games. So have we, but they haven't lost at all yet. Goal difference obviously is worse than ours, but we do need to be better than that currently. Fombatasta with 7 assists on the board already, 9 in all competitions, and Sulis is the top average rated player in the entire league. It's very, very pleasing to see us as far up there. We've got goals all over the pitch, and I do believe that we're still going to be one of the favourites for the long-term league this year, but I am a bit concerned about us today because it's the final one before the fixture congestion eases up, and I'm hoping that we can just do enough to get past Omonia in the derby, because the last thing we need to do is lose this one just like we did last season that cost us that chance at third spot. And now to Christou. So, as you can see, he's done okay this season. 3 goals on the board. Obviously got those 2 goals there. He's definitely given me pause for thought about the whole him and Sawless situation. However, we had a little bit of a run-in and a little bit of an argument. Basically, a player was complaining about the way I'd treated them in the dressing room after a match because they didn't like the fact that I yelled at them. And it's like, well, play better, firstly. So I asked Chris to talk to him. And he refused, and then got offended when I suggested that, you know, as the captain, it would probably be awesome if you could have a word, mate. But he's like, no. I don't want to do any of the work of being the captain. I just want to wear a fancy armband. So what we've learned here is Christou, terrible captain potentially at the moment, but would be great if he didn't know how to swim. I'll be honest, I'm a bit concerned that we might end up with another mutiny on our side at the moment, and I think this guy might end up being the ringleader in it. What is it with me and captains? So, hopefully we should be... Oh yeah, Duvniak picked up a slight knock as well, and he's going to miss today's game, which is not ideal. You can see we are just missing a tiny bit of fitness there. It does seem that most players were in support of me. I'm not seeing anyone that actually supports the issue that we're having so far, which is good. And obviously, Regan Booty has my back. What a man, eh? He's just the best. Now, I actually built a selection setup, so that way we could go straight back to my ideal team if we needed to. Now, obviously, Duvniak won't be able to start here, which is it's not ideal. So Stelios Christou is coming in. And you know what happened last time Christou played? In fact, I'm fairly certain the last time we played Omonia, Christou may well have been in the team. So, concerning. But since fitness levels could be a slight issue here, I am going to start Christou through the middle instead of Sawless, who could just do with a tiny bit of a rest. We get through this match. If we get the win, I am firmly confident that we can just push on after that and go for this. I can't be the only one that feels this, and I hope that I'm not, but I'm getting really attached to Ermis right now, and I don't know what it is. I think it's the team we've got and the way we're playing. Now, obviously, I believe that we'll be able to play this at other clubs too, but damn, it's so fun to watch the games at the moment, apart from the last couple, to be fair. The one thing we do have on our side in a way here is the narrow system that they play. Obviously, we play a lot through the middle as well, but it is going to give our wide players a lot of space in those flanked areas. Like, I feel like Mira and Fombatas could be just acres to pick out good passes today. So maybe there's a chance for us. I think Fombatas is probably going to be the key player in this match if there is to be one. Mendy, oh, what a start if we could get it. Oh, that would be so good. Maybe I'm being too hard on Captain, currently Captain Fantastic. But if he keeps this attitude up, we may have a problem. And I suspect it's partly due to the fact that he doesn't actually have a high enough squad status to be captain as such. I think that might be part of the issue. Oh, Miera's been brought down. Victor will take the penalty. Is that what I want? Mendy's penalties are basically the same, but he has much better finishing. So I'm hoping that this is an opportunity for Mendy to grab himself a goal here. I nearly gave it to Booty, but come on, let's not get silly. Mendy steps up, slots it home. 1-0 to Ermis. This is big. In the derby, we take the lead. Mamadou Mendy, only his second goal of the season, but I feel like if someone deserves it, he really does put an awful lot of hard work in. And he never really puts in, like, bad performances when he's playing through that striker role. It's just he's expected to do a lot of legwork for the other players. He's almost like the most high-pushed midfielder that you can imagine. Sometimes he's actually dropping deeper than like six players. But we need to capitalize on that. If we can grab a second goal really quickly, Fombatas's ball in, and it's headed away back to him. We do temporarily go top after 10 games as things stand, but obviously we need to make sure we continue this. Christou! Oh, that is glorious. That is wonderful. Fombatas with the ball in from the wrong side, and in a matter of seconds, we've gone from 0-0 and sort of just struggling to find a way through these guys to being 2-0 up in the derby. And there's a big traveling contingent here. This is a really nice goal. Christou with an absolutely beautiful finish. Lovely ball through, but that is a brilliant goal from Christou on the full volley. Well done, lad. Fair one. But he could just give us that something extra at times that we kind of need when games are getting a bit difficult for us. Still, yeah, it's a great opportunity for a ball in. And it might drop all the way through. Christou Mira! What a save. Problems with it is, in games like this and the way we're playing at the moment, it makes me go like, oh, if we were to get promoted, they'd probably offer us a new contract. And is that something we'd want to actually consider doing a year in the top flight with Ermis? Or is it just a case of that we wouldn't be able to really achieve much probably in that season, given the financial difficulties at the club? And would it be better for us? You know, we would have got them promoted, but would it be better at that point to then look to move on? Because I just don't know. Probably going to get Fombatas off in a second for Simonetti, given that we're in a fairly cushy two-goal lead here. And hopefully we can see this game out, because we have been fairly strong at the back. Not the best. I think we're the third or second best defence in the league. Oh, hang on. They've dropped it. Christou, can he find a pass? He does. And Mendy! Oh, it's a great finish. Mamadou Mendy scores his second goal of the night. Christou this time with the assist. Christou turns assistou. He now has a goal and an assist on the night. And I mean, he is justifying his position in the team, trying to prove me wrong. This touch from the defender is absolutely criminal. Christou pounces on it, but the patience to pick out a cross, dinks it in. I thought that was going to Regan Bouti. The goalkeeper has to do better. And we are now 3-0 up in the derby. Come on. And there it is, full time. Ammonia 0, Ermis 3, an away win, a great performance all round. William Bouti was actually the weak point in this team and still got a 6.9. Mamadou Mendy, man of the match, 2 goals on the night, albeit with one with a penalty, but that's so nice to see him actually stepping into the fold and doing brilliantly there. God, that awaiting media action bit took bloody forever. So, we're still not top. What happened? Oh, God. Radovic scored late on for Carmia Tissa, and they stay top of the league. If you've enjoyed this episode, and I hope you have, we are ploughing on towards the top of the league. We may not be top currently, but I feel like it's only a matter of time before we get our claws into it. Then drop a like, that'd be superb. If you are new to the channel, subscribe, that'd be superb as well. And I stream on Twitch Tuesdays, Thursdays, Saturday. Go follow over there as well. Having a bloody lovely time with Chomsa. And I'll see you guys tomorrow for Derenea. And I think we just have to keep going. I'm going to start Christou a little bit more and see what he's got. Maybe he can change my mind. I'll see you guys soon. Thank you so much for watching. Hold your gun. Capybara. Bye-bye. Going low at the end of the day, it's gone low.